गुड इवनिंग मैम। गुड इवनिंग मैम।
गुड
गुड
इवनिंग
इवनिंग
चिल्ड्रन,
मैम।
गुड
गुड
इवनिंग
इवनिंग मैम।
चिल्ड्रन, हाउ आर यू?
गुड इवनिंग मैम।
हाउ आर यू?
आई एम फाइन मैम, हाउ आर यू मैम?
आई एम गुड बेटा। सो हाउ आर द स्टडीज गोइंग ऑन?
गुड मैम,
ग्रेट, लवली। आर यू प्रैक्टिसिंग मैथ्स?
यस मैम,
यस मैम। व्हाई नो वन गिव द टेस्ट, संडे टेस्ट? Only Neha and Trilokya, no one else. Harshit, Adya. Yes, tell me, what's the reason? Why didn't you give the Sunday test? Hello? Yes, Harshit?
I went outside, ma'am, to my relative's home.
For both the days, Saturday and Sunday, both the days.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And Adya, you? Hello, Adya is there? Yes, Adya, why didn't you give the test? Hello, Adya, can you hear me? Adya, why didn't you give the test? Now you cannot say that you couldn't find the test. So many times I've explained you, and sometimes even you have given the test. No, I cannot hear you. Give the answer, Adya. Why didn't you give the test? And Harshit, you shouldn't miss the test, beta.
Ma'am, when I came home, it was like 5:30.
So you could have done after that, no? In any case, you should never miss the test, beta.
Okay, ma'am.
It's just once a week.
Okay, ma'am.
Now, since you cannot give the test now, but you can go through the questions and practice those questions, okay? Okay?
Okay, ma'am. Okay, ma'am.
Today is 30th. Okay. Let's continue with the area perimeter questions. Okay, children, let's see here. This is question number one. The perimeter of a square garden. Please read the question. Hello, please read the question, children. Read with me.
The perimeter of a square garden is 48 meters. A small flower bed covers 18 square meters area inside this garden. What is the area of the garden that is not covered by the flower bed? What part of the garden is covered by flower bed? Find the ratio, the area covered by the flower bed and the remaining area.
So what did you understand here? So many things are asked in this question. Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Let's write down first whatever we are given and what we are asked. Okay? And one by one, we'll work it out. The perimeter of the square garden is 48 meters given. Okay? Let's write down perimeter of the garden. We're just noting down whatever we are given. Then we'll see what to find out. Perimeter of the garden is given. A small flower bed covers 18 meter square area inside the garden. Now suppose if this is a garden, okay, it's a square garden. It's square garden, sorry. Let me make it a square. So this is a square garden whose perimeter is given to us 48 meters. Now inside the square garden, there is one flower bed whose area is 18 meter square. Okay. So this is 18 meter square area is there. What is the area of the garden that is not covered by flower bed? Okay. So we'll write here area of flower bed. Area of flower bed is also given. Let's write down here. Okay. The area which is, now it is asking, what is the area of the garden that is not covered by flower bed? Okay. So we have to find this area which is not covered by flower bed. Are you understanding, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So we have to find this area. What part of the garden is covered by flower bed? Now, what part? What part means how much portion? That means we need to find it in fractions. Is it half, one third, one fourth, one fifth? Whatever part is covered by the flower bed, that we have to find. Next thing is that find the ratio of the area covered by the flower bed and the remaining area. The ratio of the covered part and the uncovered part. Okay? You understood the question?
Yes, ma'am.
Everyone understood the question? What are we asked to find out?
Mom, can you tell the question again?
See here, the area of the garden, the perimeter of the garden is given to us 48 meters. Area of this flower bed. Flower bed means in this portion, the flowers are there. Okay? Okay? The flowers must be planted over here.
Okay, ma'am.
Small flower bed covers 18 square meter area inside the garden. What is the area of the garden that is not covered by flower bed? Okay, so area which is not covered by the flower bed, that you have to find out, that means this dotted portion. Okay, then what part of the garden is covered by the flower bed? That also you have to find. Now we know this much part is only covered by the flower bed. So that means we have to find the fraction which is covered. Okay, fraction of the covered part and the total.
ओके मैम.
ओके देन फाइंड द रेशियो ऑफ द एरिया कवर्ड बाय द फ्लावर बेड एंड द रिमेनिंग एरिया. ओके द रेशियो ऑफ द कवर्ड पार्ट फ्लावर बेड एंड द अनकवर्ड पार्ट. ओके यू अंडरस्टूड द क्वेश्चन?
यस मैम.
सो फॉर दैट we are given the perimeter of this square big garden. So let's find out this one side of this garden so that we can find out the area of this garden, because we are given the area of the flower bed. Okay, and ratios can be found out only when the units are equal. Okay, so if the perimeter is 48 meters, so perimeter is what, 4 into side? Yes. So that means the side will be 48 divided by 4. 48 by 4.
Yes.
That means side is, how much is the side of the big square? That is 12
yes.
meters. Right? So I can yes. write down here. Therefore, side of square garden. Right? Understand first. Afterwards, you can note down. Side of square garden is 12 meter. We found out this side. So what will be the area of the square garden?
Mom, side into side.
Yes, side into side. So area of the square garden will be side into side. That is 12 into 12.
Yes, ma'am.
Which is equal to 144 meter square. Got it? You understood this much part?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now we are also given the area of the flower bed. We are given here. Okay, now area of the square garden, which is not covered by the flower bed. So this implies area of square garden not covered. Okay, so we can find out the non-covered part. Non-covered part will be this total big area minus 18 meters square. Isn't that?
Yes, ma'am.
So that will be 144, the area of the big garden minus the area of the flower bed.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. 126 square meters. Ma'am, 126
yes, ma'am.
Square meters.
So this is 126 square meters. Okay, now what is the next thing we are asked to find? What part of the garden is covered by flower bed? What part
fraction.
Is covered by? Yes, so fraction we have to find. So we'll write down here the part of the garden covered by flower bed.
Yes, ma'am.
Part of the garden covered by flower bed. Okay, so that will be, how much part is covered by flower bed?
Mom, 1/8.
18 by 144?
Yes, ma'am.
How did we do that? Area of flower bed upon area of the garden. This is how you find the ratio, no? Not the ratio, the fraction. Yes. And when we reduce, now we both are even numbers. We can reduce it to lowest form.
Yes, ma'am.
How can we do that? Let's do.
Ma'am, 18 ones and 18 eighths is 144.
18 eighths?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, 18 eighths is 144.
64, yes, that's correct. So that's 1 by 8.
Eight.
Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So next part that is asked, find the ratio of the area covered by the flower bed and the remaining area. So we have to find the ratio of area covered by the flower bed and the remaining area. So that is 18 by 126.
Yes.
Yes. So you can write down here the next part, that is ratio of the area. You can write area covered by Flower bed. Flower bed and remaining area. Okay. Which will be equal to, you can write down here, area of the flower bed upon area of the garden. So area of the flower bed is 18 meter square and
yes,
area of the garden is 126 meter square. So now we can reduce it to lower form. Okay. So that will be 18, and if we just do with 18, then 18, 8, 7, will be 56.
171.
Yes, this is 1 by 7. 18 ones are 8 and 18 sevens are
126.
Okay,
yes.
So the ratio is
1 by 7.
1 is to 7. Okay, right, children?
Yes, ma'am.
So, did you understand this question?
Yes, ma'am.
So many
yes,
things were asked in this question. Okay,
yes, ma'am.
So, first we found, we were given the perimeter. With the perimeter, we found one side of the square garden, and with that one side, we found the area of the garden. Then we found the area which is not covered by flower bed. That was 126 meters square. And then we find the fractional part of the garden which was covered by flower bed. So that was 18 by the total area. Okay, that came out 1 by 8. Then we found the ratio of the area covered by flower bed and the remaining area. So 18 by the uncovered part is 126. So that was 1 is to 7, 1 by 7. Okay? Everybody
yes.
Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Everyone, please turn
yes,
on your videos. Show me thumbs up if you have understood. Turn on your videos, please. Yes, how many understood? Great. Harshit, what about you?
Huh?
Yes, ma'am, understood.
Yes, Trilokya.
Understood, ma'am.
Good, beta. Yes, Trilokya.
Ma'am, I understood, ma'am.
Okay, you joined late, no?
Yes, ma'am, my screen was loading, so I tried refreshing.
Okay. That's okay, but have you understood this?
Yes, ma'am, I did.
Okay. Yes, Adya, you didn't understand it. Okay, let me explain you again, children. Okay, see here, Adya. Adya, read the question carefully. The perimeter of a square garden is 48 meter, which is given to us, already given, okay? Then a small flower bed covers 18 meter square area inside the garden. So this is the big garden and this is the small flower bed. Flower bed means in this portion the flowers are planted. Okay, only in this portion. So this is called the flower bed. Now we are asked to find what is the area of the garden that is not covered by flower bed. So we are asked to find this area which is not covered. So how will we find out this? Area of the big garden minus area of the flower bed. So we'll get this part. Okay. Perimeter. Now, to find the area of this big garden, we need to find its side first. Then only we can find the area of this big garden because we are given only the perimeter. So with the perimeter, can we find a side of the garden? Perimeter is 4 into side, which is given 48. So we can find side from here, 48 divided by 4. That will give us 12 meters. Right? Okay. Now, I don't know whether you are understanding or not. No, yes, no, your mic is not working. Okay. Therefore, the side of square garden is 12 meter. Now we have found out one side, okay, which is now 12 meter. Now, area of the square garden will be side into side, that is 12 into 12, which is 144 meters square. Now, the next thing, okay, the area of the square garden which is not covered. This is what we were asked to find, no? The area of this portion which is not covered. So, that will be area of the total garden minus area of the flower bed. So, that is 144 minus 18, which is equal to 126 meters square. Okay, got it? Okay, the next part which is asked in the question, what part of the garden is covered by flower bed? How much part is covered by the flower bed? So, we have so much big area of the garden, but we want to show them that how much part is covered in fractions. Okay? So, part already we are given 18 meter square is covered area. But we have to show how much part. So whenever like this, it is asked, no, how much part, that means you have to show the fraction way. Okay. So part of the garden covered by the flower bed will be part area of the flower bed divided by area of the garden. So that will be 1/8. Okay. Next thing we are asked, find the ratio of the covered area and the remaining area, uncovered area. So we have to find the ratio of that. So the ratio will be area of the flower bed, which is the covered area, and a upon area of the garden. Now area of the garden uncovered. We can write here. Area of the garden which is uncovered. Okay. Or area of uncovered part. Okay. So that is 18/126. So the ratio is 1:7. Okay, Adya, understood now? Have you understood now, Adya? Okay. So let's see another question. This is now question number 2. The magazine charges 300 per 10. As I am reading, you should also read. The magazine charges rupees 300 per 10 square centimeter area for advertising. A company decided to order a half page advertisement. If each page of the magazine is 15 into 24 centimeters square, what amount will the company has to pay for it? Okay. So children, just understand here. See, when we give advertisement, you must have seen advertisements in magazines, isn't that? Have you seen? Yes, children, have you seen advertisements in magazines?
Yes, ma'am.
How many have seen magazines? What are magazines? Who can tell me what are magazines? Yes, say.
Ma'am, magazines are books that advertise products.
Magazines like you have, which gives you information. See, these days I've seen children don't read magazines, otherwise There are good magazines for children also. Okay. For elders also, there are magazines. Do you read comics?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
That's great. You have a reading habit. Good. Okay. So, in magazines, you must have seen there are advertisements also. Okay. The magazine charges rupees 300 per 10 centimeter square area for advertising. So in the magazine, if you want to give an advertisement for 10 centimeter square area, they charge 300 rupees. Okay. A company decided to order a half page advertisement. So a company wants to give its advertisement and they ordered a half page. Okay. They wanted half page advertisement. If each page of the magazine is the size of the page is 15 centimeter into 25, 24 centimeter. What amount will the company has to pay for it? Just a second.
Now I got the answer.
If each page of the magazine, the size is given, what amount will the company has to pay for it? Okay, so how much will the company pay for it? Did you understand the question?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
First, we are asked given one area of one page. Okay, what is the area of the page? 15 into 24 centimeter square. Please find out what is the area of the page first.
Ma'am, I found out.
Please multiply and get the area. Then find the area of half page also. Okay, then you divide it by 2, you will get the area of half page also.
Mama got the answer.
Okay. Yes, Abhya, you are asking something.
Ma'am, I got the answer, ma'am.
Hey, ma'am.
So, Abhya, you must listen carefully. You will understand, okay? If you have missed the previous class, never mind. You will understand. Now we'll do it. You will understand, okay? Yes, Harshit, what are you saying?
Ma'am, I got the answer.
You got the answer also. Okay, very
yes,
good.
Ma'am.
That's good, beta.
Ma'am, can I share?
Wait, let me work out first. Let me explain it to everyone. Okay, you can tell your answer.
Ma'am, I got 5,400.
Okay, beta. Good.
Ma'am, even I got that.
Very nice. Okay, now see. Area of the pages. What is the area of the page, Neha?
Ma'am, 360 meter centimeters square.
How much is A?
360.
Okay.
So centimeter square.
Okay. So this is 360 centimeter square. So here everything is in centimeters, so we need not to convert anything. Okay, so now what is area of half page? Because the company wants to give half page advertisement, no?
Now we have to divide it by 2.
So what is that?
It is 180
centimeters. Okay, now, wait. Okay, now Trilokya will tell me. Trilokya, how much are the charges for 10 centimeters square?
300 rupees, ma'am.
Okay, charges for 10 centimeter square is 300, okay? Is rupees 300, this is given to us, right? So, but the company, the advertisement magazine people will charge, they have to charge for 180 centimeter square, no? They have given the rate for 10 centimeters square, but they have to charge for 180. So we'll do with the unitary method. So what are the charges for 1 centimeter square? What will be the charge for 1 centimeter square?
Ma'am, 30
rupees, ma'am.
Yes. This will be 300 by 10.
Ma'am, which is rupees 30.
Yes, so this will be rupees 30. Are you understanding, Trilokya? What did I do here?
Yes, ma'am.
See here, for 10 centimeter square, the charge is rupees 300. For 1 centimeter square, the charges will be 300 by 10. Okay, so which will be 30 rupees. You get it? Okay, but we want to find the charges for 180 centimeters square. This is what we have to find out, no?
Yes, ma'am.
So that will be 180 into rupees 30.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so 18 3 is 54, and we have 2 zeros here. So that means the total cost, what amount will the company has to pay for it? So the company has to pay 5,400 for the advertisement. Okay, half page advertisement. You understood? This implies, you can write down here the concluding line. Company has to pay rupees 5,400. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Anyone has a doubt in this question? Any child has a doubt in this question? Adya?
No, ma'am.
I'm asking Adya. You didn't understand the last step. See, in the last step, it is the charges are 10 centimeter square. The charges for 10 centimeter square is rupees 300. It is already given in the question. Okay. So, first, how can we find for 180 centimeter square? So, 180 centimeter square. We will first find for 1 centimeter square, the charge will be 300 by 10. Okay. So that will be rupees 30. And for then we will multiply this with 180, and so we get 180 into 30. See, here I explained you, for 10 centimeter square, the charges are rupees 300. For 1 centimeter square, the charges are 300 by 10. 10 goes this side, it will become divide here. So this is 30. And for 180 centimeter square, this will be 180 into 30 rupees. Okay? Understood now, Adya? Yes? Understood or still you want more explanation? Any child? Trilokya?
Ma'am, I understood, ma'am.
Okay, good. Okay, let's see another question. Let's take another question. Find the number of square shaped tin sheets of size 20 centimeter that can be cut off from the square tin of sheet of size 1 meter. Okay. Please understand the question. You have to find the number of square shaped tin sheets of size 20 centimeter. Square shaped tin sheet. Tin sheet means of metal. 20 centimeter that can be cut off from a square tin. This small sheet is being cut from a big square sheet, which is whose side is 1 meter. Okay, this small sheet is cut from a big square sheet whose side, one side is 1 meter square. So that means that what will be the area of this big sheet?
1 meter.
1 meter into 1 meter.
Which is 1 meter.
So, area of this, just understand first. So, area of the big sheet will be 1 into 1 meter square. 1 meter square. Okay. Right. And now, this area of this small sheet is given. One side of the small sheet is given as 20 centimeters. So, we should have everything in one unit. So, if we convert 20 centimeter to meter, that will be how many meters? Trilokya will tell me.
Ma'am?
This will be how many meters?
0.20 centimeters.
0.20. Okay. So, I'm not writing 20. Okay. That's 0.20. Right? Understood this? Don't be doubtful, it's correct. Okay, so 0.2 meters. Okay, so what will be the area of this small sheet? 0.2 into 0.2? Yes. So 2 is 4 and you have decimal point here. So this will be this much, 0.04 meter square. And area of this big square sheet is 1 meter square. Right?
But how can area be less than its side?
How will area be?
Less than its side.
Area is not less than its side. It's not less.
Mom, but it's 0.04 meters.
Ah, so that's meter, no?
Oh.
Okay, that's meters.
Mom, even 0.2 is in meters.
No, bachi, this is in meters, 0.2 meters. This is equal. 20 centimeter is equal to 0.2 meters. We haven't changed anything. Okay?
Okay.
We haven't changed anything. This is equal. We have just converted.
Okay.
So let's write down here area of the cut off from a square tin sheet. Area of the bigger, we can write here, bigger tin sheet is 1 meter into 1 meter. That can be written as 1 meter square. Okay. Area of smaller tin sheet will be 0.2 meters into 0.2 meters. Yes. Everyone understood this part. We converted into meters and we found the area. Right? Okay. Now the question is saying, find the number of square tin sheets. That means how many square tin sheets will be required in this full tin sheet. Okay, how many small sheets will be there that you have to find. Okay, so what will you do to find the number of square sheets? Number of square tin sheets will be equal to area of the smaller sheet. Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
When we multiply by the area of the smaller sheet, will be equal to the area of the bigger sheet. Are you understanding?
Yes.
Number of small tin sheets, when I multiply with the area, I will get the area of the complete big sheet, is it? So number we don't know. Number of sheets we don't know. So what will be the number of sheets? Number of sheets will be area of the bigger sheet upon area of the smaller sheet. Okay. Area of the bigger sheet upon divided by area of smaller sheet. Okay. And what is the area of the bigger sheet? This was 1 meter square. Okay, 1 meter square. Area of the smaller sheet is 0.04 meter square. So this is 0.04 meter square, right? And when I divide this, what will I do? First, I'll convert this denominator part to a fraction form. So this will be 4 by 100. I can write it like this, 4 by 100. And then I take the reciprocal of this. Sign will change to multiply. That will become 100 by 4. And now, this will be 25, right? 4 ones are, and this is 4 twos are 8, and this is 5, this is 25. So, how many are the number of sheets?
125.
Now, tell me how many understood this? Hello?
Mom, I understood, Mom.
Mom,
understood. Okay. Yes, Harshit.
Mom, understood.
Bhavesh.
Mom, I did not understand.
Understood, Adya. Yes, Adya. Hurry up, Adya. Tell me, have you understood? Or I'll explain again. Okay, so all have understood, right? Adya is not answering.
Mom, I did not understand.
Yes. Navesh, you didn't understand? Navesh, you didn't understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, please see here. Area of bigger tin sheet is 1 meter square. See, we were given one side of the bigger sheet, right? So I found its area by multiplying side into side. That is 1 into 1 is 1 meter square. Area of the smaller tin sheet, I was given the smaller tin sheet, one side was given, that was 20 centimeters. So when I converted it to meters, this was 0.2 meters, right? So area of the smaller tin sheet will be 0.2 into 0.2, which is equal to 0.04 meters square. You understood this much part?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, then how do we find the number of tin sheets? If we are asked to find how many are the total number of sheets, if I have to cut so many sheets inside this, so how many will that be? How will we find that? No, that we have to find. How many sheets are required in this? Can we cut out of this? So to find that, how many the total sheets will be cut? Will be number of sheets multiplied by the area. One sheet, okay, number of sheets. How many are the total number of sheets multiplied by the area of one sheet? That will give us the area of the complete big sheet. Isn't that? Are you understanding?
Yes, ma'am.
So, to find the number of sheets, what did I do? This area of the smaller sheet, I took it this side. And it changed. Here it was multiplying. On the other side, it got divided. So that became area of the bigger sheet divided by area of the smaller sheet. Understood this part?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So area of the bigger sheet was 1 meter square. And area of the smaller sheet was 0.04 meter square. Understood this much?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, same way as we have learned in fractions, how do we divide this? So, since the denominator is in decimals, I converted this to fraction. So, 0.04, when I change this to fraction, this will be 4 by 100, right? And when I take it, when I take the reciprocal of this, the sign will change to multiply. Okay? Understood this part?
Yes, ma'am.
How do we divide fractions 1 divided by 4 by 100? How do we divide this? We were doing like this, no? The sign will change to multiply and the reciprocal.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Like the same thing I have done here. Okay. So that came out to be 25. So number of sheets are 25.
Okay, ma'am.
Understood now?
Yes, ma'am. Understood.
Good. And Adya, what about you? Understood now? Okay, children. So you must practice these sums. Okay? Right, children? So this much for today. You must practice these sums and practice for your Sunday test also. You have fractions coming this time. Okay. Thank you, children. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Have a nice day.
Thank you. You too.